Hey, what's going on guys? Cyril God back again today with another video playing Call of Duty World War 2 once again. And if you haven't been keeping up to date on Twitter or Facebook and whatever, you won't know this, but a new leak for Call of Duty just happened today, and it's sort of, let's not deny it, what we were all expecting. Supply drops are finally, well, we knew they were coming, we've been told when we can buy them, you know, etc. But these are the leaks of what weapons will be coming and what supply drops we'll be getting. So first, the supply drops, three new supply drops come in: legendary, supply drop, epic, and weapons. So don't really know what's going to be in legendary and epic, probably just legendary and epic loot, you know what I mean? But weapons, I think that's a fairly good idea if they're going to do this, at least, you know, give us a way of actually earning these weapons. So that's a good thing, but what we're all sort of wanting to know is what weapons will be coming. So there's so many of them today that I'm going to be telling you about that I'm probably going to start a new series. I've sort of been planning this anyway, but I'll go over every weapon in the game in just a bit more detail, you know, the history of the weapon and all that kind of stuff. So today I'm just going to go over really, really quickly, you know, tell you what they are and what they do. First up, Gewehr 43, a semi-auto German full-size rifle created to replace the bolt action for the main infantry. That simple. Next up, the Type 5. It's a semi-auto rifle known as the Type 4. It's a very rare gun. There's only about 250 of them made for trials, but it was basically just a Japanese M1 Garand. That's it. Up next, the Volkssturmgewehr. Probably said that horribly wrong, but it's pretty much just an STG-44 or Sturmgewehr, but a much cheaper, easier gun to make, last ditch for the German army coming to the end of the war. Next, the Beretta 38, an Italian submachine gun. There's nothing crazy special about it, sort of just your average submachine gun. But next is a very sort of famous submachine gun, the Sten gun. A gun I actually wanted in the game, finally come in. It's a classic British submachine gun, super cheap make, super crude is probably the word I'm looking for, but also pretty reliable and really good at what it does. Up next, a gun most of you probably won't know, it's called the Breda 30, Italian full size machine gun. And from everything that I can tell, possibly one of the worst machine guns made during the war. Horribly slow fire rate, super low mag, and also fired a really underpowered round. So basically not that good. It'd be kind of interesting to see how they balance that. Up next, fan classic, M1919, a full-size machine gun, but basically set the standard for other machine guns of its type, so that'll be fun. Next, MG81. Originally designed for aircraft use, was adopted for its high fire rate and high durability by the Germans. Overbuilt gun, just worked. Up next, another gun that I said would be coming is the Arisaka. Pretty much everyone will know what that is, infantry weapon of the Japanese army. Not sure which Arisaka they'll add, but either way, it'll be interesting to see. Probably one of the guns I'm most looking forward to is the Winchester 94 lever action. Most famously known for just pretty much being a cowboy gun, but they were used in the war, very effective, and that'll be probably a sniper I'm guessing, but that'll be really interesting to use. I can't wait to use that gun. Up next, most people won't know what this is. Everyone thinks Enfield just made rifles, but the Enfield number 2. So sort of an average pistol really. Was pretty reliable for what it was, but it just didn't fire a big enough round. It was just a sort of also underpowered. But is what it is. Up next, Wolfer P38. the replacement for the Luger. Also, probably one of the best pistols from the war. Super good. Up next, another one of probably the worst guns in the war, the Reichs Revolver. Very old pistol from the late 1800s, I think it was 1882 this gun was built. But it was used by the German army when they were running out of weapons to give troops, so they had to just give them whatever they could. Finally, I won't include pictures of these. You'll probably be able to work out what these are. Melee weapons. First up, the ice pick. Just basically a spike. Second, combat knife. Probably just your normal sort of combat knife. And third and finally, the trench knife, which will probably be my one of choice, because I think that's just a really cool looking knife. But yeah, that's it for me today, guys. Those are all the links I've got for you. So if you did enjoy the video, please be sure to like and subscribe. I've been Zero God. See you in the next video.